The integrity of the quiz or exam is one of the primary features of SAFE. Let us see in this video as to how a teacher can monitor a running exam live and also keep a bird's eye view of any students who may be trying some dishonest means. For this, let me create a new quiz. I am actually going to clone this quiz which I just now tested. Go to quiz settings. Clone to the same course. I'm going to name this demo 18 June. Clone it and then go to the list of quizzes. Here is the cloned quiz. Quiz settings I have for 2 minutes. Let me just increase it to 3 minutes. Rest of the settings I will leave it as it is. Save, run and publish. At this point, let us go to the student interface. Here is the quiz which I just created. You can download. Student presses start and at this time it is asking for password, which the instructor can provide after pressing start. SHJJ. SHJJ. Okay. Now the quiz is started. So one of the main ways in which a student can potentially try to cheat is by going out of the app. So let's see if that works. I'm going to click this middle button here. So immediately SAFE pops up a red screen saying take me back to quiz or exit quiz. So once you press take me back to quiz, it will take you back to the quiz. I will also show you what has happened in the live dashboard on the instructor side. So immediately the instructor has gotten a warning here. You see here, app was not focused for 8 seconds. Let us see now what happens if we do it once again. So there's actually a 10 second overall timer, which if you exceed, it will report to the instructor with a red flag. So you can see here that critical warning with a red flag has come. Then the instructor can immediately call out this particular student's name and check what is happening. So this is one of the primary features. Let me now use another phone to make a phone call to the phone which is currently taking the quiz. Okay, it's actually ringing now. You can see that it is ringing here. Now, if I answer it or even if I don't answer it, a live monitoring message will go here. Let me refresh this. You see that phone is ringing. Okay, so if the phone is actually taken, now you are going to get another critical message saying that phone call in progress. So in the previous quiz, the quiz timer ran out before I could show all that I wanted to show. So I have created a second demo here. I'm going to run this. The same procedure. Let me type the password after starting the quiz. DHUB. So the next feature I wanted to show you is that actually the network of this phone is also blocked. The student's phone network is blocked. What this means is that if somebody else tries to send, let's say, a WhatsApp message or a Facebook chat or something like that, it will be blocked. It won't even come to this phone. So for this, I am going to use the WhatsApp web interface of the other phone, and I'm going to send a message, demo message on 18 June. Okay, so you see here with this single tick mark here that it has not actually reached the other side. This is because the network on the recipient phone, this phone, is cut off because of the use of safe quiz. There is a VPN running for the entire duration of the quiz, which will block all network connections other than to the safe server. I will also use this same running quiz to show a few more features as the quiz time is running. We can see here that in the quiz summary, the teacher gets a bird's eye view of how many students are total in this class. 9 are not even seen. They have not even downloaded the quiz. There is no student in the downloaded quiz state. One student, that is this account, is currently taking the quiz. Okay, so as soon as that submission comes through, it will this entry taking quiz will turn to 0 and quiz submitted will turn to 1 after submission. So you can see here that there is a per student status. There is one student taking quiz, other students are not seen because this is a demo. So this gives a bird's eye view of the entire proceedings to the teacher. I'm going to show one more feature, which is what happens when the network gets cut off. I'm going to intentionally turn off my network before quiz submission. So it is going to auto-submit when timer runs out. And since network is cut off, you will see something happening. Okay, so it tries to submit. At the time of submitting, if there is no network, there is no major issue as such. The submission is stored locally within the student's phone itself and can be submitted whenever network comes back up. So let's see the status here. This student is still shown as taking quiz because the submission has not come through. The timer has run out. If you look at submissions, there is nothing because the student is cut off. Okay, let's say now the student's network comes back up. I'm going to turn on the network here. And even if you go out of this screen, you can always click on this pending submission to submit it. If there is a pending submission, it will show in that screen. Okay, so now it says submission is successful. And you can also see here that if you refresh this page, the submission has come through. So just like attendance submission, quiz submissions also in SAFE are robust to various kinds of network issues. So note that even while starting the quiz, the student does not need network because all the student has to do is to type the decryption password, assuming that the encrypted quiz has already been downloaded to the student's phone. During the quiz also, network connectivity is not so much of an issue. If network goes off in between, it's not such a big deal. And at the time of submission also, if there is temporary network outage, no issues. You can always recover the submission later from the student's phone. Of course, the teacher has to ensure that only after the submissions come through to the server, the student is allowed to go away from the exam hall, if it is a serious exam. Now, if we see the Run Quiz tab here, there is a button called Stop Submissions. By default, the SAFE server will accept submissions from students up to 5 minutes after the exam or quiz has ended to account for various network issues. Automatically, once the 5 minutes runs out, it will stop accepting submissions. If the teacher feels that submissions can be closed beforehand. You can simply press stop submissions here at any time. It is now 5 minutes after the end of the exam which I just showed. So you see in the run quiz tab that it has already stopped submissions. If you want to allow submissions, you can, but there is typically no reason to allow submissions after it has been stopped. So now if you go to the submissions tab, I will show you one other feature. We have a feature called out of envelope quiz submissions. Now what happens if a student faces network connectivity issues well after 5 minutes after the end of the quiz? So a student is not able to submit, and for let's say 1 hour a student's network has problems. Even then there is no issue as such. The student simply has to approach the teacher. When the student submits, it will go into what is known as out of envelope quiz submission. So this means that the student submission has come to the server, however it is placed outside of the envelope, logical envelope, which contains all the valid answer papers. Now if the student has a valid reason why his submission is so late, then he or she has to explain to the teacher, and the teacher can just move the submission from out of envelope to in envelope. They can also move a submission from in envelope to out of envelope like this. If for some reason that submission is invalid, you can also move it back, move it inside the valid envelope and reload the page, and that submission comes back inside the envelope. So one other feature here is you can use the search bar to search for a particular student. You can search by either the name or roll number or username, any field. This works both in the submissions tab and also in the live status, live dashboard. So for example, you can search for S1, it shows only that entry. So if you have let's say 100, 200 students, and if you want to look for a particular student, you can use this search feature. So that is how SAFE provides different facilities for managing an exam and live monitoring of an exam.